Foxborough had been wronged. He seethed. He burned. He wanted revenge.
Shakespeare's Prospero, one of the great characters in world literature, is a man with good reason to seek retribution. And as the Tempest begins, he's conjured up a storm to shipwreck his brother and the King of Milan after they had wronged him.
Remember to have the king and his son aboard.
In one reading of the 400-year-old tale, it depicts a classic cycle of violence, where the victim becomes the perpetrator of evil deeds. That is, until this moment in the play, when Prospero realizes there is another choice.
The rarer action is in virtue than in vengeance. They being penitent, the sole drift of my purpose doth extend not a frown farther. Go release them, Ariel.
This was the Colorado Shakespeare Festival on a recent visit to Thornton High School, just north of Denver, presenting an adaptation of the play with a very specific goal, as part of an anti-bullying program aimed at reducing teen and preteen violence. Director Tim Orr says using Shakespeare is a natural choice.
Shakespeare is an expert in violence. There is so much violence in all of, and intimidation, and he explores every possible way: family violence, nation violence, kings and queens, power, husband and wife, children and parents. The thing about that Shakespeare does so well is he always shows the moment of choice that these characters had. They could have gone that way, or they could have gone this way. And if you keep going this way, this is what eventually happens.
This is the monster of the Isle.
The idea was conceived 2 years ago by the theater group in conjunction with the University of Colorado's Center for the Study and Prevention of Violence. By the end of this school year, nearly 150 schools will have participated, involving 30,000 students from all grade levels. Beverly Kingston, who heads the center, says the idea is to get students thinking and talking about the various roles people play in bullying situations.
It's so amazing that Shakespeare wrote this so long ago, but there really is a place in it for everyone. There's characters in the plays that are more the bullying type. There's some that are the victims, some that are more the bystanders. And so it really lends itself to a conversation about all those roles.
Who calls there? Sir Topis the priest, come to visit Malvolio.
Last year, the program featured Twelfth Night with the tormented character of Malvolio, servant to a rich countess. Crystal Isley is one of the actors.
Poor Malvolio gets bullied beyond belief. He is asked to wear crazy things. He's given a note from people who say it's from somebody else, and, you know, so-and-so likes you. This happens in schools all the time, right? He is mercilessly teased for that.
Peruse that letter.
These days, of course, it happens in forms not known to Shakespeare, including cyberbullying. And in this version of Twelfth Night, that harassing note arrives on Malvolio's cell phone.
Alas, Malvolio, this is not my writing.
After the hour-long abridged performances...
What if somebody got in trouble for something that they shouldn't have been doing or whatever?
The actors lead small group workshops to get students to role-play modern-day scenarios.
Right. And this is in the parking lot after school. No physical contact, though, but I want to see it. You ready? Hit it, guys.
Man, I'll kill you. You almost got me caught. I'm gonna get in trouble. You know what my dad's gonna do to me?
Within the workshop, we then focus on, oh, so what in your world? What do you guys see? What issues do you guys see that you are dealing with, that where the cycle of violence is continuing or bullying is happening? And we ask them first, what do you know works?
These are basic acting exercises that we have taken into the classroom and applied to this situation. Now, that's all an acting class is taking situational material, changing the outcome, making choices. Why did you make this choice?
Ninth graders Stephen Banks and Jay Trujillo said they could relate well to the characters in The Tempest.
I think if everyone just chose virtue, it would be way better, because, like, it's the better way to go. Because if you, like, get revenge against someone, it's just not going to, like, fix anything. It's going to make you feel bad, and it's just going to escalate into something worse.
Like how Ariel told Prospero that he should forgive him, them, his brother and the king. It's like one of those things where, like, if you see someone, like, something happening to somebody else, you should probably stand up and, like, tell them to, like, leave them alone.
We are such stuff as dreams are made on.
Thornton language arts teacher Cheryl Newey says she's under no illusions that a two-hour Shakespeare session will change a school climate overnight. But she thinks it's a useful tool to encourage students to speak up.
Well, ironically, the kids that were very outspoken in the breakout session were our kids I would label sort of our kids that are on the fringe. And I thought that was very interesting, that they felt comfortable in this type of setting, raising their hands and asking James many questions. And whereas many of the kids that are probably more popular, they were, quiet.
Are they, Ariel, safe?
Crystal Isley said she's often approached by students who say the workshop has helped them realize they have other choices than violence. She described an encounter with one young man earlier this year.
He said, I saw myself in that character in Tempest, that Ariel character that is trying to make everything better and but at the same time is enslaved. And he gave me some specifics about his world and what was going on with that and what he was doing to solve some of the situation.
As you from crimes would pardoned be, let your indulgence set me free.
It's certainly not the first time Shakespeare has been adapted to speak to contemporary issues, and the program's creators say they're hopeful that theater companies in other cities will adopt similar programs.